better? Okay. All right. Good to hear, be in the house of the Lord this morning. Good to have so many people participating in our worship this morning. And those of you who've come to join us, all are welcome here. And if you see anybody wandering in the streets this week that look like they don't have any place to come for Christmas Eve worship, just bring them on. We're glad you're here with us today. Announcements. We have announcements for today.
I just want to say that we had a wonderful time last night, and I want to thank everyone that participated in whatever shape or form or whatever. It was good food, good fun, good fellowship. What we can ask.
Other announcements. Christmas Eve services, candlelight services, I know there's one in Atlantic that folks in Stacy are probably going to end up going to. We will not have a candlelight service here. Anybody know of other churches in the area that are having a candlelight service?
First Church Moorhead.
First Church Moorhead is? Okay.
The last one is at 11 p.m.
Okay. You know what time Beaufort by the Sea is?
I have no idea. I'll have to ask.
Okay. Harper's Island Methodist Church is doing an afternoon communion thing, but it's a float in and out. It's not a candlelight services. They're serving communion every 15 minutes with an abbreviated worship of some sort. Yeah, starting at 3, I think. I haven't had any more feedback from any of the other local churches as to who's doing that. Somebody said check the internet. If I discover that somebody closer than Beaufort is having a service, I'll get in touch with Terry and we'll put it on the Facebook page. Well, if there are no other announcements, let's pray. Almighty God, you love us, and you know us well enough that we need to worship if we're going to keep our lives going in the right path. And we need to worship with others who believe as we do in your Son, in salvation, in life and eternal life. And so we gather together in your house this morning to worship you, to thank you and praise you for what you've done, and to praise you for you who you are. We pray especially today for the children and for the choir as they come to lead us in worship. And we pray that you would touch our hearts for those who are participating and for those who are just enjoying and receiving. Touch our hearts today by the power of your Holy Spirit. And we pray this in Christ's holy name. Amen. Our hymn of praise is among my favorites. Joy to the world. Oh, we're going to do the light of the Advent candle first. Yeah. It says that right here on this.
She's letting me do all the reading. This is the third Sunday of Advent, lighting the candle of joy. And our reading comes from Psalm 126, which is a psalm of the ascents. When the Jewish people would go to celebrate, they would sing these songs. I'm not going to sing. I'll leave that to the choir.
Praise the Lord.
When the Lord brought back the captive to Zion, we were like men who dreamed. Our mouths were filled with laughter, our tongues with songs of joy. Then it was said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us, and we're filled with joy. Restore our fortunes, O Lord, like streams in the Negev. Those who sow in tears will reap with songs of joy. He who knows our weeping, carrying seed to sow, will return with songs of joy, carrying sheaves with him. You know, hope is assertive and peace is subversive. But joy is rebelliously provocative. How dare joy make its way into our dreary, despairing world? How dare joy show up in all its flashiness? It even gets a pink candle, for crying out loud. How dare we, in the midst of war and hate and despair, deep division, grief, violence, come together and rejoice? How dare some shepherd start speaking of good news and the heavenly host declaring peace on earth in the midst of a violent Roman occupation? But if they did, why can't we? Why can't we sing for joy that God is breaking open into the world again? Why can't we be rebellious against the politicians and news anchors and doomsday sayers that there's joy in the world? Joy to the world. We light this candle because God is provoking us to sing for joy, to sing and dance and laugh so hard we have tears, because there's peace and hope in this world. God of joy, call us to sing, remind us to dance, tickle us into fits of laughter, because you are in our world and in our lives and doing something new right now. Death and despair have nothing on you, and we rejoice in you, our Savior. Amen.
Amen.
When I read that prayer, Rodney just read for us, I never imagined God tickling me. But you know, there are times when I think he needs to. Thank you for doing that. Our hymn of praise is Joy to the World, something that an angel announced, and we are still receiving number 246 in our hymnals.
look at the Christmas tree. It is so beautiful. The Christmas tree is often an evergreen tree. An evergreen tree is a wonderful tree because it stays green throughout the year. The Christmas tree reminds us of an everlasting life given to us through the birth of Jesus. Let's celebrate the birth of Jesus by decorating the tree. There are many things that look beautiful on the Christmas tree. First, let's place candy canes on the tree. Which stands for the name of Jesus. Well, the white part of the candy cane represents the purity of Jesus. Finally, the red stripes represent the blood of Jesus that Jesus shed on the cross for us all. Brightens the darkness in the world. Jesus is the light. He is the light in the dark world. Jesus is with us through all things, even through the night. On the night Jesus was born, there was a bright star placed in the sky to lead the wise men. Our Christmas tree is topped with a star. The star reminds us that we should follow Jesus. Jesus is the light of our salvation. Jesus is the star. Follow the star to Jesus. If you have not met Jesus, why not get to know him during this season? Jesus will bring you Christmas all year long. Oh, Christmas tree, how wonderful you are. You are a symbol of Jesus. Your limbs are evergreen. You are adorned with candy canes, which stand for his birth, and the rock on which he built his church. You are covered with bells which ring out the news of Jesus. And you have ornaments which represent Jesus' unending love for us all. You have lights which brighten the tree. Just as Jesus brightens the darkest night. And you have a star to remind us that we should all follow Jesus. Oh, Christmas tree, you are a glorious reminder of this special season, the season which honors the joys of Christmas, the joy of Jesus.
Everybody's good.
Okay.
Thank you, boys and girls. I think that's everybody.
I want to thank the children. Thank you for the gift, both the gift of being up here and talking about the Christmas tree and also the gift that you passed out today. Thank you for helping. We're hoping you're going to help us sing a song a little bit later, right? You guys all know that? They do a good job. That was kind of an offering all in itself, wasn't it? It is time for our offering. The ushers will come. We'll receive the gifts, tithes, and offerings prepared for the Lord today. Accept our gifts, that they would bring joy to heaven, and that you would help these gifts be used so that you might receive honor and glory now and forever. Amen. We're going to do praises and concerns a little bit differently this morning. If you have a praise, I'm not going to ask you to tell everybody about it. If you have something that you want to praise the Lord for today, just raise a hand. Just raise a hand. Okay. And if you have something that's burning in your heart that you know that we need God's help for, just raise a hand. Let's pray. Almighty Father, as we gather for worship today and as we prepare to celebrate the gift that you've given us in your Son, Jesus, we pray that you would help us to celebrate by us remembering how well you have kept your promises to us and all of the work that you're doing by the power of your Holy Spirit in us and through us and here in our land and in this broken world. We pray, Lord, that for those who are suffering, for those who are going through a time of trial today, or even in this season, Lord, that you would help them to discover that joy is just around the bend for those who love you and are called according to your purposes. And that joy we will receive, Lord, when the time comes and is right, because you have promised it. We lift ourselves up to you today. Be your ambassadors in this world. And we pray especially for those who have not discovered the joy of knowing you. Hear us now as we join our hearts and our voices together in praying with the words that your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, taught, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory.
Having heard it, the familiar sound of Christmas is in the air. From high atop church bell towers to the Salvation Volunteers at the entrances of department stores, joy is ringing out with the melody of heaven's song. Once the unmistakable refrain falls upon our ears, we can't help but join right in. For heaven's song is our song. It resounds within the hearts of every man, every woman, every child, and calls us all to worship the Christ of Christmas. So, ring the bells, lift your voices and sing. Unto you is born this day in the city of David, a Savior, which is Christ the Lord.
Thank you.
We've been listening to the sounds of Christmas this season, but to believers in Christ, they're much more than that. They are reminders of the coming of the Christ child to earth. They are the songs that the angels sang to announce his holy birth. They are the sound of his love.
Thank you.
Christmas songs continue to find their way into the hearts of every generation. Just imagine for a moment what it must have been like generations ago when Mary, the expectant mother of Jesus, heard those first sounds of Christmas. "Fear not," the angel said to her, "for I bring you glad tidings of great joy. You shall give birth to a son, and you will call him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sin." At that moment, Mary's song must have been anything but one of joy and celebration. Instead, hers must have been one of uncertainty, fear, and loneliness. In the quiet hillsides of Galilee, a mother's desperate cry for mercy echoed through the night.
Me. Oh, when a precious rose.
journey from Nazareth to Bethlehem, order to be counted for the census, as if they hadn't endured enough already, Mary and Joseph found themselves with nowhere to take shelter, nowhere to have any rest, until an innkeeper, who was sympathetic to Mary's condition, offered a stable filled with hay.
This was heaven's child. Thank you.
tells us that all who found thee bowed down and worshipped him. There was no regal procession to announce his birth. He was merely cradled upon the hay in a simple feeding trough. And yet, all who saw him knew in their hearts that he was the promised Messiah and that he had come to change their lives. Over 2,000 years later, we still recognize that Jesus, the Christ child of Bethlehem, come to change our lives forever. God spoke in his Son, and the sounds of his love have never ceased. Still today, his love calls to the hearts of all, inviting us to share in his love and in the freedom that only he can bring us.
Thank you.
been here with you all. I do want to mention that Kathy, once again, has put all of this together for us and been patient with us and brought us to where we were today with the help of the Lord and the Holy Spirit, without which we can do nothing. But thank you. Thank you all in the choir, and thank you those who participated. Thank you, children. And thank you all for showing up in a terrible day. And just a word, it's likely to be not very nice outside, but that can be said most days. But remember, the sun comes up tomorrow. Joy comes for all God's people. Joy, even in the midst of hardship. So, go now in peace of God. Proclaim the word. Save the world, or at least your part. Go in peace.
Christmas.